One of the most important contributions of Watson-Strogatz's paper was presenting a simple model of how small world networks could be formed. That is, how a network could be formed that has low average path length, yet still has high clustering. Here's how the model worked. The model works by starting with a regular network. By regular, I mean that every node has the same pattern of connectivity. For example, this node is connected to each of its neighbors on either side, and similarly, this node has the same pattern of connections, and so on. So we're going to say that there's n total nodes, m neighbors per node, with capital M being the number of links. So for this example, we have 10 nodes. Each node has two neighbors, and thus there's a total of 10 links. What's going to happen in this model is that some of these links, which are right now between nearest neighbors, are going to be rewired. That is, they're going to be ripped apart and then reattached to some distant neighbor to model the making of a distant connection. In this model, there's a parameter called beta, which is the probability of rewiring each link. For this example, let's let beta equal 0.2. That means each one of these links has a probability of 0.2 of being rewired. So right now, the way that this is going to work here is I'm going to randomly choose beta times m links. So that's going to be 0.2 times 10, which is 2. So I choose two links, the ones that now appear in red, just chose them at random. And I'm going to rewire one end of each of those links to another randomly chosen node. So here's where I rip them off their existing end and reattach them to a randomly chosen node. So here's our new network, where most of the connections are between nearest neighbors, but there's two exceptions that are long distance connections. As usual, we're going to look at an implementation of this model in NetLogo. Here's what the interface of the model looks like. We have the parameters node count, that's how many nodes there are, how many neighbors each node has, and our beta parameter, the probability of rewiring. So if I could do setup, I have 10 nodes, each connected to its nearest neighbor, so each node has two links, two neighbors. And I've set beta to 0 now, so there's no probability of rewiring. Nobody's rewired. Now we can look over here and we can see the degree distribution. This shows that all of the 10 nodes have degree 2. We already knew that. This also tells us the global average distance between pairs of nodes, 2.5 hops, and the clustering coefficient, right? 0, no clustering in this one. There's a couple of other things we can do. For instance, we can click on this Show Neighborhood button and then click on a node, and the neighborhood of that node is shown. We can also show the link distances and click on a node, and that says from this node, here are the distances to that node. So those are different things we can do. I click Setup again to clear those. Okay, so now I can change beta. So what happens if I change beta to 0.1, which means that one of the links will be rewired? I click Setup again, and you see this link was rewired. Here, the global average distance went up, but that's because we have so few nodes. Okay, so let's do this for a more realistic number. Let's do 100 nodes, beta back to 0, setup. Now you see that same regular pattern of links with 100 nodes. Global average distance is 25 hops. Now let's change beta to 0.5, 5%. Now we do setup. Now remember that here, beta is the probability that a node gets rewired. So each node has a 5% probability of getting rewired. And it actually rewired a lot of them. And we see that the global average distance went way down from 25 to 9.24. So this relatively small percentage of rewiring allowed the distance to decrease dramatically. It also changed the degree distribution. Okay, now let me try rewiring 10% of the links. Well, it went up, but if we do it again, it goes down because it's random. There's a lot of randomness here. We still have low clustering. Clustering shows up when we have more neighbors. So let's change the neighbor count to 4, the beta back to 0. Here, each node is connected to 2 neighbors on either side. If I change beta here, here the distance is 12.75. Let's make beta 5% again. Set up. Here, both the global average distance decreases dramatically and the clustering increases. You'll get a chance to play with this small world network model for the homework. Let's finish off this subunit by a summary of what we've learned about small world networks. We saw that there's a spectrum of networks from very regular to very random. Regular networks have high average distance between nodes and high clustering. The high clustering comes in if you have more than just the 2 neighbors. Here we have 4 neighbors per node. Then a random network has small average distance but low clustering. Whereas the small world networks, which are in some ways more like real world networks, have small average distance and high clustering, similar to the real world networks that Watts and Strogatz investigated.